Wayne Baerwaldt, curator of this exhibition called Field Portraits of Contemporary Western Culture. And the exhibition really started with a bit of an investigation on my part, looking at the way people in Western culture throughout the prairie provinces document themselves and write themselves into a regional or mostly a family history through regional history books in particular. So I've gone through various parts of Alberta and Saskatchewan in particular, and meeting with people in homes, and most everyone has a regional history book that places them and their parts, members of their family, into a regional history that is quite broad and very engaging. Sometimes there are snapshots taken by a family member, but other times, most times now, it's a commercially shot photograph in a studio where the subjects are dressed up, usually in their Sunday best, and they do it on a regular basis, but these regional history books, of course, capture them in the 70s or 80s. I was kind of interested in how things were changing, so I've looked, generally speaking now, and subjectively, of course, at the work of five photographers to look at how their documentation of subjects in the field, so to speak, you know, at work in the field, or for example at a rodeo, taken away from the shoots and put, you know, in front of a plain black or white curtain, exactly what they're getting. And in some part, of course, it's digital photography that is at work, but it's also the role that the photographer plays, you know, the interaction with the subject. And after observing most everyone here, from Louise Fabini to Sheila, Spence to Blake Little, there is an active role on the part of the photographer to make that subject come alive or to take on a certain role, being that being a bold, adventurous subject, or a brutalized subject, or a timid subject, or a feminine subject, etc. There are finer ways to detail the making of that subject, and I was very interested in that rapport. And some of these pieces you see in this exhibition absolutely embody that sort of relationship between the photographer and the subject, making that presence more pronounced in some ways. John Bowie, who is has five photographs here, he's a little bit different. He's out on the range, he's photographing the landscape, but really makes the point of photographing his subjects, other ranch hands, family members, and they come out differently. They are very different. He doesn't have that rapport, direct rapport with his subject when he's taking their portraits. They have more of a snapshot feel to them, but they're all very closely cropped. They're close-ups. They remind me in some ways to the kind of aesthetic that comes from TSN and sports networks generally, that really zero in on every bit of face, skin that they can with usually a sports subject. There's a bit of fetishization involved there. So with John, it might be quite unconscious, but 25 years ago, I don't think you'd see snapshots like this. I wanted to stay close to this idea of field photography versus studio photography, even though there's a fluidity now between the two, so much so that it's kind of hard to tell. Although what really surprised me was that any of these characters that Blake worked with, all of the characters that Sheila worked with, you know, were really taken out of a rodeo setting or a field setting, a ranching setting, for a minute, and produced a certain presence, you know, in front of a screen, you know, all of a sudden. Whereas if you, in the past, if you went again to a commercial photography studio, there's a lot of time to prepare, you're composed. So I'm kind of amazed at what Blake Little and Sheila Spence in particular were able to take from their subject. The scale of these works, the presence of some of these subjects in a different light makes people sort of come awake, you know, and they see what they think is familiar differently. So that's what I'm hoping for too, is that they that there's that recognition that, I don't know, takes you somewhere else or has you see your own world, your immediate world, a little differently.